merger has begun. Earth is under attack. And it is glorious!
No, it is not. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, of course, I'm your favorite random man, Future King of YouTube, Terrence Woods in the building today. I hope you guys are having a nice day where you're at, where you're from. So, guys, this is going to be more, as the title says, this is going to be a reaction to and a discussion to Mortal Kombat Annihilation, because what I wanted to do, I wanted to have my green screen up, and I wanted to, you know, have a little backdrop, have a little nice little intro. I have Scorpion probably tell me get over here or kick me somewhere or uppercut me somewhere, however I wanted to do it. But time was pretty much of the essence. I wasn't able to do such things. So so pretty much here, what I'm going to do is talk. I'm gonna elaborate on some. I'm trying to anyway, because Annihilation, growing up, I had high hopes for this movie, and I really did want. I wanted to see, because there are some good video game adaptations out there that's really good. Talking about the likes of the first Mortal Kombat, talking about Detective Pikachu, I want to say Tomb Raider, and there's some more out there. But those really are the main ones that really stuck out to me, because the first thing I know about Annihilation, I was like, oh cool, we got Shao Kombat, we got Robin Shu coming back as Liu Kang. We got the lady who played Katana, Tulsa. I can't remember. Oh yeah, Talisa Soto as Katana, and I don't know who Sonya Blade's character is. I don't know who Johnny Cage's character is. It was really mind-boggling to me. I was like, I wonder why I didn't get Lyndon Ashby. Those of you who know, Lyndon Ashby was Johnny Cage from the first Mortal Kombat. He also had a part in Resident Evil, I want to say Extinction. I also covered that too as well, because I was really doing my research. I was really blown away that we got in the character from the original Mortal Kombat movie to be in, to be in that film. But anyways, so, YouTube, some of you probably heard him already. His name is Matt Midmuscle. He does like What Happens, when he goes down the pile and talking about movies and video games. Why did they do so bad? What's going on? Because director for Annihilation was a cinematographer, and pretty much the producer of everything. He thought like, oh, okay, let's give everybody raises. Let's give them a new spot. And he clearly said it, and he said it in Matt B. Muscle's video. He probably thought, well, that was the worst thing that he ever could have done. Because the thing, one thing that really, excuse me, that helped the original Mortal Kombat do so much better was the fact of the matter is, one, the acting was great.
Mother, you're alive.
Too bad, you will die.
Well, in a cheesy way, great. But then, like, another thing was some of nobody really came back. Like I said, we got Robin Shu as Liu Kang, who I think he does a great job of Liu Kang. Tulsa Soto, you know, I think she did better than Driver, the Rock movie. I don't think she had that many speaking lines. But, we had a new Sonya Blade. I can't remember why the original Sonya didn't come back to the cast, but I do. I remember what Chris Lambert said and Lyndon Ashby. And again, you can check this out on Matt Muscle. He gave the full rundown. Again, I'm just going to paraphrase it. Chris Lambert, the Highlander, he didn't like the script, and the reason, and Lyndon Ashby didn't come back because he was supposed to get paid for this film. But he didn't, so that's why he pretty much kind of dropped. Again, paraphrasing again, I'm gonna give you the link in below so you guys can check out Matt McMuscle's video talking all about Mortal Kombat Annihilation, why it did so bad and how horrible it was. So like, again, the characters we have, we got Lynn Red Williams, who was also he was also an American Gladiator, back the old school American Gladiators. I think we also got Motaro on here. I think he's also part of the American Gladiators. I think it was definitely Motaro. I think Darren McBee. I think he's American. I think he's one of American Gladiators, and definitely Lynn Red Williams. He was Jax, and I was excited to see Jax. But Chris Conrad, who played Johnny Cage, he was only in the film for like I don't know what, maybe 5, possibly 10 minutes. He gets off real quick. Shinnok was actually in this movie. I didn't know Shinnok was actually in the movie. We had Shiva in. Shiva was in there, and you know, Ermac, Rain, Baraka. Baraka looked terrible to me in the movie. He was so awful. And we had Melina in there. We had a Sub-Zero too. Then we got Reptile. But all right, before I start going hard on some of these characters, like I said, with Mortal Kombat Annihilation, it was loosely based off Mortal Kombat 3. I think a little bit of 2, because I believe in 3, Johnny wasn't in 3. If I really remember, because I'm reading as right now, it said, while featuring characters brought from Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3, there's also plot elements of Mortal Kombat 4, but these scenes were cut out from the final film, while the original attacks casual moviegoers as well as gamers, Annihilation created exclusively for the game, for the fans. So yeah, it was more, and I agree, it was meant for the fans more so than the... most of the average moviegoer, Lawrence Kasdanoff, I hope I'm saying his name right. He said he was trying to make the film even more spectacular than the first. Again, the movie had a great lot more budget. It was like over $73 million in the U.S. Annihilation was 3 times more ambitious than the first Mortal Kombat. He said RDM of the sequel was to shoot for more fights. And it said shoot more fights, more special effects, more outworld, more everything. That was the problem, and I said this many times doing these reaction tubes or little discussions I do. Sometimes more can be harmful. It's okay to give us less. You go more, it don't work out right for you. It don't work out right. To me, Matt Muscle said this, and I totally agree with him with this. What made the first movie so good? It was character driven. And they had to do some reshoots, and these reshoots worked. Again, those you don't know, and I covered this again, Paul W.S. Anderson, and I may go on a rant, I hope I don't go on a rant, but Paul W.S. Anderson, he directed the very first Mortal Kombat. Now, the reason he didn't do Annihilation, because he was doing Event Horizon, which I also love. I love Event Horizon. That's one of my favorite movies from him. But, like I said, and I'm going to say this again, I don't know if that's the only time I'm going to say this. So, how are you going to follow the lore, somewhat to a T, keyword somewhat, of Mortal Kombat, and you mess up the lore with the whole entire Resident Evil movie series? Now, granted, I give the first one a pass, and the second one I give it also somewhat of a pass. Because at that time, I said again, during my Resident Evil movie marathon, at the time, we didn't know the events leading towards the mansion. So I get that problem. And the reason I get the second one to pass, because it has some good nostalgia stuff. But other than that, the whole entire movie franchise was bad. But anyways, and Paul Douglas Anderson, he knows that the producer and the director had a hard time with the script. Like I said, it focused too much on the action. And I love action movies. I'm going to go ahead and say that right there. I love action movies. But the problem was, it was too much of it. It was, like I said, he wanted more everything. Instead of just building characters. And like, instead of building characters, it didn't work out right. Because those who remember, the story wasn't there. And that was the problem. I think we didn't know the true backstory. Jay was working with Shao Kahn. She was working with Shao Kahn, but she was trying to seduce Luke Kane for whatever reason she was trying to do it. I don't know. It was weird. It was weird. And like, even with James Remar playing Raiden, and I hate the fact they cut that. I like James Remar. I do. He worked with what he got. Because he's really good on Black Lightning. But for them to do Raiden like that, it hurts, man. And like again, night. Well, like even some of these characters, we got like night wounds. They didn't have that much time to shine, and that's what I kind of hurt. Matter of fact, I forgot to mention that Darth Maul himself, Ray Park, was reptile, which I enjoyed. Matter of fact, I'm just doing a little reading right quick. Let's see. This one says Styles of the first movie was cast returning characters of the original, almost completely overhaul. Only Robin Shu, who played Liu Kang, and Talisa Soto Kitana reprised their roles, while the only actors to return Keith Cook as Reptile in the first film as Sub-Zero's brother. even the fight scene with Scorpion was like, it wasn't there, man. It was like, action was there, but it was, to me, it wasn't enough character thrilling stuff. Suckers! And it, like, it's okay to have some downtime with it, but it just really didn't work. So that's what really hurt this film. And to me, it felt like more of a cash grab type of thing for me. And like I said, like we all know, it's sad that there's a lot more bad video game movies than good video game movies. So you know, it really hurts. But like I said before. I didn't like, again, having Shao Kahn being the main antagonist, the main bad guy, it wasn't bad. The guy who played Shao Kahn, he wasn't bad. Brian Thompson, he wasn't bad, but just everything just wasn't in the cards for it. And even the fight scene with because I want to remember, it don't go in the best of how Jax lost his arms. I know in Mortal Kombat 9. It tells us how Jax lost his arms thanks to Ermac. And so again, like, I want to say the problem with video game adaptations. The problem with video game adaptation, guys, the problem is like what I have with anything else when I'm talking about these type of topics, is that it doesn't follow the core. It's okay to change the story a bit to fit the story you're trying to make, but if you just get rid of the core elements of that game, that movie's not going to sell. That movie's not going to do good as you want it to do good, and that's the problem. Again, like I said, guys, this is more so a discussion than more of a reaction to it. Usually, how the reaction I do is more so me saying what happened in the movie and stuff like that. But by me not doing what I was able to do, I couldn't give that to you guys. So I really want to apologize about that. And I hope I'll do a better job when I get to the Tomb Raider stuff. But I do got another couple of reactions to it. I do want to sound off before we leave today's episode here, guys. Again, first off, I want to say again, like, check out Matt McMuscles, What Happens About Mortal Kombat Annihilation. He goes a whole lot more in depth than what I'm talking about right now. I'm just talking about how bad the movie was. Really, that's what I'm doing. But again, don't forget, the next video game movies I'm doing is Tomb Raider. I'm doing the whole Tomb Raider series. My buddy, my good friend, Mastermind, wanted me to do a reaction to the prequels of the Thing movie. The Thing was one of my favorite horror movies, and I enjoyed it so much. So I'm definitely going to do that. My buddy Victor Quick One, he want me to do a reaction to one episode to Ghost Story. I think it's episode 9. Me and him talked about this, and I still to this day still crack up about it. I'm definitely gonna look into that. And I think that's about all the reaction to that's coming. I rambled on long enough, guys. Thank you so much for your time, your patience. I appreciate you guys so much. And I kind of figured this video was gonna be kind of long since this is being discussion and all. And yeah, make sure you like, subscribe, tell your friends when we come to Random Side. We do have the cookies, and you're going to see on the screen called hashtag Meet Corey as Kenshin. That's my goal. That's my dream. One day I will work and meet with Corey as Kenshin. Spread the word. And please, I'm going to say it again. Please! You guys stay random, and I'll see you all in the next video. Yo, I ain't